you guys just couldn't seem to knock down a shot. What did you see was going on there?
Well, I think we just came in a little too antsy. It was a big game, and we just were a little bit too pressed. We couldn't buy a shot, and it really hurt us. We let our offense dictate the rest of the game, and we can't let that happen. So we just need to take this game and learn from it. That's the only thing we can't do.
Kamiko, I don't know how long you were in the back of the room. Did you hear Holly when she was talking about you saying the only person that can hold you back is you?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your reaction to hearing Holly say that?
I believe it. I mean, my teammates know it. I know it. It's something that I've struggled with, but trying to get out of it, I am. It's a work in progress. So, I mean, hopefully I can just build from these couple games and be there for my team like I need to be.
And there were times today you were the best player on the floor for Tennessee. You went right at Baylor. I mean, you weren't intimidated. You attacked the rim. You made the passes you need to. What was the difference for you in this game? Why were you playing so well?
I think it's just my teammates and my coaches were constantly in my ear and just encouraging me and telling me to keep it up, you know. Like Holly said, sometimes I'll be my worst enemy and let fatigue get the best of me. But just having my teammates like C, who likes to touch me, and then Rail hit my hand, and LZ pulling me aside and telling me to keep it going. Even J-Mo and Heather, you know, were in my ear. So the way I performed today was because of them. I mean, they were just in my ear. They was encouraging me and telling me to keep it going. So I didn't want to let them down.
Cierra, did you feel like that? You mentioned your offense dictating the rest of the game. Did you feel like this team ever gotten any kind of a comfort on offense? Was it just a struggle all night on that end of the floor?
I think there was a glimpse of the game where we kind of got some offense going, but I mean, every single time we got on a run, they just answered. And so that's tough. You know, you feel like you're slowly chucking away at the score, and then you look up at the score and you're still down 25. So, I mean, it kind of plays with your mind, it plays with your confidence. But, I mean, we just got to stay strong, learn from it, stay together.
Cierra, this is a young team. None of the sophomores have played here. I imagine Nia, Jasmine, and Bashara just got a lesson in college basketball, what it's really like out there to play. Does the team understand that? That you just played at probably one of the most tough. They're 101 here against non-conference opponents. They last lost to a non-conference game in 2006. Does a young team realize what they were up against?
I mean, nothing can. I mean, you can tell us. You can try to explain what the environment is, what the team's about. But, you know, until you actually put on the jersey and lace up your shoes and get there, you know, you really don't understand what type of environment you're playing in. And, you know, Waco is a great place. They're very supportive of the women's basketball team. And, you know, they have some great fans. And, you know, now we see as a team, you know, what we need to go against and what it's like to be top three in the country.
What do you take from this kind of a game? What's the lessons that you guys will want to talk about amongst yourselves?
I think the first thing is we need to play D and get boards to win basketball games, to win championships. That's what it came down to. When our shot's not falling, it's not going to fall every single night. You know, we've been pretty fortunate where we've been able to hit shots throughout the season. But, you know, we just couldn't buy one today, and that's when we need to fall back on our defense. So that's the biggest lesson that we need to learn is just continue to board the basketball and play tough D, and that's going to win us ball games.